making a video on building a combat airplane. Possibly might be a club project. First thing I usually do is I usually go ahead and I tape the board up. Now, you can use just clear, maybe a brown like that. And then they add a little color to it if you like. In this case, I have blue tape and I have orange tape. Now, I decided that I'm going to have the blue side up so that when I roll these up, I'm going to have orange stripes down here, and that I'll have orange tips on my vertical fins. So let's get started here with measuring out. First thing I usually do is I take and I find the center line of the board. Now this is 30 inch width, and I'm going to divide it at the 15 inch mark. Alright, and it's a little, not quite 30, so I'm going to move it a little bit. And we'll have a line here. Mark down here. Draw a line for the entire width of the board here. Okay, so we just run a line straight down there. Now I've already drawn these lines, so I'm faking it here. But then the next thing I do is I come down here and I measure out 1 inch from that center line on either side, and then down 8 inches. Alright. On either side, I'm going to measure down 8 inches. Put a line, stop at 8 inches. And draw line across. Come down about an eighth of an inch and draw another line across. Now the reason I do that is this is going to be cut out, and this little piece of wood here, it'll be hanging down off the motor mount. Well, in that case, that's a bad example. Here's a better example. Piece that will actually go through that slot. And just to give it a little more stability, a little more strength. Now, okay, so we've got this box drawn here. And then I'm going to go up here and I'm going to come from the center line. I'm going to make 6 inches. And 6 inches. Okay. Now, come down to the bottom down here, and I'm going to get, well, maybe you might not be able to see it there, but I'm going to come down over here, and I'm going to come up 6 inches from the end of the board and put a mark. I've got a mark up here, right here where this stops here, and I got marked down here. Now I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to measure up 6 inches from the edge of the board, put a mark. All right. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'll go ahead and draw the line between those two marks, and the mark here, the 2 inch or the 1 inch off center line here. Now I'm 1 inch off my center line. I'm going to draw a line. Okay. Both sides, 1 inch off the center line. I'm going to go ahead and draw a line. All right. Now, that's 1 inch off the center line. Okay. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take a pin. Because that line I just drew, I want to be on the other side. So I grab a pin, get a pin, here's a pin. Grab a pin, all the way through, all the way through, down here, all the way through, over here, all the way through, up here, all the way through. Okay? Now, I'm going to roll it over, and that line that I just transferred to the other side with the pins, I then line up the pin holes, and I draw a line. Okay? You line up the pin holes, and you draw a line, both sides. Now here's the While I've got it upside down, I'm going to mark out where I'm going to put my arrow shaft. Okay, I use about a 14 and a half in this case, 14 and a half inch arrow shaft. And I'm going to remove the foam here, the paper and foam, but not the bottoms, the top of it actually. But I won't go all the way through. I'm going to cut out on this side, but not all the way through. Now, if you got a, once you score that, if you got a dull, old, beat up screwdriver, it peels that out pretty well. Now, let's see. Up here. And maybe I had a tool there that I could cut that with real easy, but I don't, so let's just do it this way. I'm going to take my, I'll go ahead and I'm going to measure out this thing right now, and, or I'll cut this thing and remove that. It's as good a time as any. Alright, I like clamping down my ruler at the one end. Got a lot of junk over here now I don't need. Okay, let's get this out of the way, that out of the way, and this out of the way, that out of the way. Alright, let's pull this over here where I can clamp down the board. There we go. And I take a trusty knife here. Make a little mark so I can see where I got to end here. Okay, starting here. Didn't go all the way through, I hope. Cut the ends here. Take this dull tool here and I'm going to push down just to open up a cut. Okay, now start on this side so that you can see it a little better. Okay, it should fit in here. There we go. That's going to get hot glued in there, and it gives it a little more stability this way. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to cut my hinge. Since I got this board upside down now, I might as well go ahead and do it. All right, try to get that straight, otherwise it won't fly. Every time you get a control, it won't fly straight. Make it 2 inches, and this is the 2-inch ruler. You could mark it out and do it that way. But I just, since I have the tool, might as well use it. This is still on the bottom side. I put the relief for the control surfaces on the bottom side. It makes it look a little better. Okay, I cheated. I built a tool to cut that. Now usually what I have to do is after I get this opened up a little bit, I'm probably going to have to take some sanding block, sand this out a little bit so I got free movement here. My tool doesn't cut as well as I would like. Little stiff. I'll have to sand that out a little bit. Just take a sanding block and get in here. There's a little ridge in here that doesn't come out. Get rid of that ridge and it's fine. When I'm done, I'll take and I'll put hot glue in here and I'll get as much of it back off again. I'll just keep on use some sort of tool to smear the black hot glue out. That makes it hinge very, very strong. Never had a problem with those opening up once I put hot glue in. Now, at this time, I'm going to, seems I acquired a magnet somewhere along the line there. Take this back out of here. I haven't glued it down. I'm not going to glue it down until I'm finished with the other side. Okay, I'm going to cut these two lines here that I made. And I believe I've got a razor blade tool that will cut paper cutter. I guess I don't. Thought I had a tool set up for that, but I got it somewhere else. Oh, it's in here. Arrow shaft. Nope, don't seem to have it here. So I have to do it the old way. So I take and I pull this down to where I can get a clamp on here. Alright. Okay, if this doesn't work out and I go too deep, it's actually going to be taped anyway. There's going to be tape run around that just for to protect the edge. So it's not the end of the world if I should cut through. Okay, let's see what I got here. See if these will break easily. That one breaks quite nicely, and that one breaks quite nicely. There we go, we got our basic shape. Now, next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take and I'm going to my ruler, and this line here, there's a line here coming up that was at 3.5 inches, if you remember, and then the line that I made for the diagonal comes to a point here, comes to a point there. I want to I'm going to mark that a little bit so I can see it, and mark it over here so I can see it. I'm going to put ruler across. And we'll go from this mark to the edge. OK. Okay. Then I'm going to take my 2-inch ruler. I'm going to lay it along this line. And I'm going to put a line there. So it's basically, it's just a mark. And I'm going to cut from the 6-inch mark down to over here, which should be just fine. Go ahead and take it all the way out to the edge. And right here. Can't quite see this line here. I'm going to have to kind of, this time I'm just going to go ahead and do some trimming here so that I can see what's going on. Working on a dark surface like this makes it does make it a little harder. I'm going to start with that point there. Cut that out. Here. There. And this line here I drew. Remember, I drew a line from 6 inches from the edge here, in the very first segment here, and I've got a line here that I drew just now, so I go from that 6 inches to there, cut that now. Okay. Me that part right like that. Okay. And the same thing over here. Got 2 inches away from here. I laid the ruler down along that line. And I got a mark right here. So I go from the 6-inch mark again, if I can find it again, where's that? Here it is. 6-inch mark right there. To that. There we go. And I still got that up here. Yep. Okay. Do a little trim in here. It's not quite wide enough for the motor mount. It doesn't quite fit there. So I'm gonna have to do a little trim in. Oh, let's see. I'd say on both sides it looks like. So let's just go ahead and trim that out now. Where's that gotta be now? That's gotta be on right there. So we're just gonna take just a hair. Just a teeny tiny hair there. It's not going to take much. Let's see how that worked out. It's right on the line now. And this one here has to be just a hair trim on this. Any luck at all, would never had to trim this, but since it's just a little off. Alright, I Let's see what we got here now. All right. That fits in there very nicely. Okay, it's actually going to go in here like this because this is the motor mount. See how I made this? Basically, got a little piece of foam in there because screws are going to come through and the battery's going to be up in here. And if the batteries come slamming back to the back, I don't want it to be punctured by the screws. I think this one, yeah, it would work very nicely. Alrighty. This isn't hard to build. Actually, it's very similar to Flight Test's power pod. They've got a special section on how to build their power pods. You build it similar, except to take a 2-inch square piece of 1/8-inch plywood, drill a relief in the center for the in case the shaft sticks out of the motor, 4 holes for the motor mount, and I tape this. You don't have to quite tape this as much, but that gives it a lot of strength. That's actually not a bad power pod there. Alright, next. Got that. Alright, let's cut a little slot here. Here. Over the other side. And push this out of here. Okay. And see if we get this fit. And basically there's your really good start on it. Now, let's get the fin set up. I don't glue anything yet. Do the fins. Now the fins will be double cut 3/16. It's a double cut. What you can do here now is you just measure over 3/16 of an inch. The outside, or the inside, it don't matter, but the outside. Measure over 3/16 of an inch. I can't see here. About the width of the foam board. So if you got a piece of foam board, you can just kind of lay it up on there and make your mark. Take another, lay it on there. Make your mark. Okay, and you having a hard time seeing stuff here, folks. All right, and you take your knife, down, go over to the original line. Break that. Good idea to bend it all the way over. Peel this piece off here. Okay. Clean this out a little bit here. And this, well, I believe before we were interrupted by a battery on the camera ran out, that I had just got finished cutting out the relief here for the fin to go up into. Now, if you look, I push this down and I roll it up against the side like that. Now when I do that, it should come up pretty close to, if not touching, the, well, you could call it KF foil. It's not really KF foil because it's not measured out properly. point in time, what we're going to do, we're going to start doing some gluing. Pretty easy stuff. We're just going to take and we're going to run a bead of glue here, down here, down along here, down along here. I'm going to put a bead of glue down the center here. Glue's pretty strong. You ever try to break a piece? Pretty doggone strong. We're just going to hold that down nice and flat there. Okay. Now you need a square for the next part. Some glue in here. I'm going to put it right in this edge here. Down there. Okay, make sure she's sitting down there good and tight. Put my square on there. Let everything settle for a while. Okay, let's go across here to the other side. If I had a good editor, I could see. Yep, this would hold. Down, hold that nice and square. Now while I'm holding that, make sure this is going to fit good. Yep. Takes a long time for this to kick off because you're actually on, this is basically an insulating material. And it's trying to keep the heat in, which keeps the glue from cooling. Using your square again, make sure you're still square. Try to push down good and tight. Against the table. Got a little extra glue here I'm going to get rid of. Now I made a mistake. Be sure you don't make the same mistake because it's going to cost me a little bit more work. Be able to set it down here on the end of the table here. And find my arrow shaft. Should put my arrow shaft in first. Would have been better. Plenty of glue in here. But I put my arrow shaft in first so it get a little easier to do this as it is. I can do it on the corner of the table, which works out okay for me. If you don't have corner of table, I guess it would be a little bit more problem. You should have put the arrow shaft in first. heck of it, I'm gonna give a little extra on the arrow shaft here. Okay. Arrow shaft in. And, well, we're getting a little closer there, aren't we? Got an elevator that works. We've got a place to put the motor. Simply use this one here. Like that. Put that on there like that. But, I think I'm going to make that blue to kind of give a break up here. So that when it's out at a distance, you can see it a little bit. So I'm going to make a blue one. Now the other thing I have to do yet is I have to add the third tail. Now that's going to come up right about there, just ahead of the elevator. Now these will be split. There'll be a hole here, so that's not the end of the world. But I'm going to put a third one in. I find that having a third fin in the middle, this will fly the way it is right now. But having a third fin in the middle does two things. Gives it a lot more stability because the air coming off the prop hits this fin and really smooths things out. It's quirky. And gives you a place to hold it so you can launch it. I'm going to shut this down for now. I got a phone call. Well, let's go ahead. Now I could use this as the motor mount, but in actuality, I want to make it blue. So what I'm going to do is I have to measure out the sides. The sides here have to be 1 1/2 inches, 1 1/2 inches. Okay, the center will be 2 inches, and I have to make two cuts here that are going to be the width of the foam board. Alright. So basically you measure up 1 1/2 inches, set your foam board down, put a mark here and mark here, measure up 1 1/2 inches on an end, put a mark here and mark here. Now, go up here, do the same thing again, 2 inches away from that. This is a solid 2 inches from this cut here to this cut here is 2 inches. Again, 1 1/2 inches. Now, gets a little squirrely here because your center piece here is going to be longer. You need a longer piece in the center here to come all the way down. You can leave that open. You could cut it straight across here and you'd end up with a gap. Not a bad thing. The gap lets air into the battery, but if you want to have a nice finish, more of a finished look, you have all the way down. So at this point in time, I grab a ruler. And I cut the thing off to the size of the centerpiece. All right, and I cut. Well, cut this here. It's at an angle, but I didn't explain this. So I'll explain this. Now, in order to get the slope, that's a 45-degree slope. This is 1 1/2 inches, so I come from here, this point here to this here, it's 1 1/2 inches. Running, cutting on the outside. And that's what you're going to end up with. Okay. Now, break that. Break that. Remove the pieces there. Okay. Now, this is going to be, since you want this to be, the motor mount to be exactly 2 inches, and this part here is 2 inches, so you're going to roll this in on top, just like that, so that you end up with a 2-inch box. Now, before you go any further, and this is the part I usually forget, you want to take something. I use a, just compress this, because you're going to want to bend this. So basically, you want to compress that like that. All right. Now, in this case, there's other ways of doing this, but this is the way it's just easiest right now. I could sit down and figure it out and do this a little different. But what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to take and I'm going to glue this part right here to that side like that. You put it on a piece of metal like that, it really sucks the heat out fast. And do the same thing here. Roll it up. So I've got a finished edge here. Okay, now I've got two good finished edges there. Alrighty. And we're going to go ahead and get everything that's stuck to it. Alrighty. Let's go ahead and glue this down here. Alrighty, we're going to push this down like this. Push it like that. Get my square out here. Now that square ain't going to work. Use this one here. That's pretty close to square there. Pushing down on the table like that, make sure that it ends up the way it should. Alrighty. I close up the gap just slightly there, and I just lay the glue right down on that edge. Like that. Just down on that. That and grabbing it square again. Make sure it ends up being square. Over time, my cutting board has gotten a little warped. When I do this, sometimes it kind of gets goofy and doesn't end up square, so I have to come push down everything. Okay. The garbage is stuck to it there. Alrighty, now let's see how this is going to fit. That's pretty close, not 100%. I'm going to wrap tape around that anyway. So let's go ahead and put some glue down here. Using the table again. On a little bit of pressure there, so I make sure that glue is dry before I release it. Alrighty. There's my nose. Okay. Alrighty. next thing I want to do is I want to get my, shouldn't use my, there we go. Alright, this one here is ready made and it is 2 inches wide, so I'm going to go ahead and use this one here and put it on there. It's going to stick down just about the right amount. If you see the square 2x2, you put it on there, it's going to drop down just about right enough to go into that slot that's cut into the top of the board there. So I think I'm going to just do this one with hot glue because I'm going to tape it, the combination of the hot glue and the tape should be adequate to hold it just right. Ouch. Okay, get the hot glue off my fingers. Ouch, 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 ouch. And I want to put a little piece in here to put the battery and add a little strength to it. Cut this a little bit. Better hurry. There we go. Well, that was hot. Okay. That gives a little more strength to the motor mount. And it provides protection for the battery. And boy, I got a lot of hot glue on my fingers. Woo-wee! Off here. There we go. I wish I hadn't done that. Now, right now, got my, let's do that. This guy here, put him up here. Through. Settle this in here. And basically, short of putting in my Now, one thing I do is I take, I've got my center line there, so I know where it's at, but I take my bin that I've made, I just make a duplicate of what I've got on each side, and I put little pieces of cut off sharpened stick on here so that I can line it up. That makes it a lot easier to line up your tail. Alright, pretty much. That's an airplane there. Still have to add the components. Now the servos can go right here at the corner of the motor mount. Just put it right there. Bring it in. Basically what determines how far where my servos are going to be is how long my wire is to get to my receiver. My receiver will be right here. I'll show you on this other one here. My receiver will end up being on the side. And on the other side will be my speed controller, motor. And these are the construction flag wires that I use, that you see, the little marker flags that you see, I use the wire from there. But that's it, basically that's it right there. I'm going to go ahead and finish this up, but anybody that's done any work with these airplanes have a pretty good idea how to finish it up.